All right, so let's talk about exporting this Photoshop layer image into a JPEG that is optimized. We are going to use a command which is found under File, Export, and is the Save for Web. We are going to use this to make our JPEGs very efficient, very light, but with high quality. As you can see on the right-hand side, inside of my layers, I have a bunch of layers for this reference sheet. And if you look to the bottom left of our user interface, Photoshop is telling me that this file is 158.3 megabytes. So what we're going to do is first we're going to flatten this image, and then we're going to save a copy, and then we will unflatten the layers version and save the layers version in case we want to recycle those images. So to flatten the image, we can do this two different ways. We can go to layers, and at the very bottom, we can go to flatten image, or we can go to our layers and the options button right here on the far right hand side, and we can go again to flatten image. When I do this, notice that our image has been flattened. Now, because we had all those layers, the file was 150 something megabytes. Now that we have flattened this image, notice that it is 48.2 megabytes. Still, this is a very heavy file for email and to put on the web. We are going to maximize this by going to File, Export, and we are going to select Save for Web. Now you're probably asking yourself, well, we can do the same thing by going to File, Save As, and save it as a JPEG. Absolutely. What we can do further in making this file more efficient is to use the Save for Web. Now, the way that the Save for Web works is that we can look at the original by clicking on this tab, and it's going to tell us that this file is 48.2 megabytes, but we need to compare it to the version that we are going to maximize. If I go to optimize, right, it's going to give me the optimization, how big this file is, based on the settings on the right-hand side. So what we want to do is compare the before and the after, the original and the optimize. And for that, we're going to use what's called 2app. Using the 2app, we can compare both the original, which is on the top right here, and the optimize, which is right here. Now, I can zoom in by clicking on this plus sign right here. And what I can do is compare the quality that I'm going to lose. And then I can use the left mouse button to navigate to a specific place. I like to compare parts of the image that have high contrast, like this white background with this area right here. Now, when we select the original, we don't see any of the optimized presets. So you have to click on the bottom image to bring up the presets to optimize. We are going to select JPEG, then we can go to low, medium, high, or very high, and maximum. What I recommend that you do is select high, and as soon as I do that, notice that the quality is pretty much identical. I don't lose anything. I can move this to an area with a lot of detail. Let's say, for example, right here, and you can compare the two images and notice that I'm not losing any of the detail. Notice that we're going to go from 48 megabytes down to 2.43 megabytes. If I was to select, for example, a high quality, but then drop the percentage down to, let's say, 30, the setting changes. That is because low, medium, and high have a specific quality. So right now I'm at medium, and you will notice that the quality is still really, really good comparing it to the original. However, I went from 48 megabytes down to 1.17 megabytes. So the optimized version is 1/48 of the original. So this file is incredibly light. We can put this on the internet and it will upload really, really fast. We can email it and on and on. Now, as soon as you have a setting that you like, what I recommend you do is you save a preset. Again, select the optimized version at the bottom. And now you can save this preset. As you can see, I have some presets already created for myself. I have this one called Save for the Web Quality 80, and it's gonna give me a really good size. But if I wanted to create a new preset, what I would do is first change the setting. So I'm gonna go to, for example, medium, and I really like this one right here. I'm not losing that much quality. Look at this area right here compared to the original. And now I'm going to save this preset. There it is. And I'm gonna call this one Save for Web, and I'm gonna type in medium underscore 30. And I'm going to hit save. So now I can select between the web quality of 80 and the web quality of medium of 30. And as soon as I hit save, it will ask me where do I want to save it. So I'm in my desktop right here, and I'm going to call this file the same as the original, but I'm going to get rid of the word layers. And there it is. Now, the last thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to go to my history, and I'm going to travel right before I flatten the whole image so I can get all my layers back, as you can see. And now I'm going to save this one by going to File, Save. And as you can see, I will have two versions of this file, one with all my layers and another one that's been flattened and optimized for the web.